Denver Radio Real Estate with Cheryl Garlock, a show about all things real estate and home-related in Denver and Colorado. Covering topics from buying to selling a home, construction, financing, foreclosures, and more. Helping the consumer to be educated and informed. Here's your host, Cheryl Garlock.
Hey, and welcome to the Denver Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties. I am so glad you guys could join me today on the show. I have a couple of great guests I got to tell you about. First, I've got Chris Zadra. Did I say that right, Chris?
No.
No? Oh, God. You guys know how long I've been trying to say this. What's wrong with me, man? I can never get that last name right. Zadra.
That's all right. It's something close.
Something close.
Exactly.
Chris Z. You know, they got Jay-Z. We got Chris Z.
It'll be Chris Z.
Chris Z. I think that'll be your new nickname. We'll go Chris Z. Chris Z with Homebridge Financial Services, you guys. And Chris is going to be talking to us about mortgage financing. And I can tell you, you know, if you're buying a piece of real estate, you pretty much really, if you don't have cash for the whole thing, you need a lender. Isn't that right?
Yep, got to find somebody to help get the money together.
Yeah, and you got to understand the rules that lenders play by. He who has the gold makes the rules. You know how that works there. I also have a very special guest, Tracy Wilson with 1031 IPX Exchange. Ah, you guys ask, what the heck is that? We're going to talk about what exchanges are. You know those things that are referred to as tax-deferred exchanges? Your accountant or CPA might have mentioned that a time or two, and Tracy is going to enlighten us with more information about that today. You definitely want to stay tuned for that. Welcome to the show, Tracy.
Thank you very much. Appreciate being here.
I'm so glad you could be here. But anyway, you guys, okay, first of all, I got an announcement I want to make. I've got a good friend of mine that heads, or at least did head anyway, a Kiwanis group here locally in the Denver area. And they have a program there called Kids Against Hunger. It's a Kids Against Hunger drive. I want to tell you guys about it. So if you guys are looking to donate a couple of hours of your time, either Saturday, July 12th or Saturday, August 10th from 10 to noon, they could certainly use your help there. They actually make they have made over $2.5 million meals for kids and since 2008. This is really a phenomenal opportunity. They also can use some donations there. Let me tell you where you go to go find out about this. Again, it's the Kids Against Hunger Drive. Really, go to their website, you guys. It's a kind of an interesting story on the founder and what brought him into this mode. But this is a legit deal. Anyway, and I know it's legit because I know the guy who's arranging all of this here. Go to www.kahdenver.com. KAH, Kids Against Hunger, Denver.com. Here's a phone number for you to get a hold of Ken directly. 303-478-9888. 303-478-9888. They need some volunteers at the Fern Warehouse Food Bank at 2830 South Zuni on Saturday, July 12th from 10 to noon and Saturday, August 2nd from 10 to noon to help with that food packing preparation there. This is really, really a great thing that they're doing.
What a great program.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Really quickly, and I want to talk to you back to real estate. You know, that's what this show is all about, right? Okay, you might be finding our market is heated up a little bit, but when we start also heating up in the marketplace, as you guys already know here, we're getting more and more inventory that will come on board, even though it's going fast there. So sometimes we have offers written with contingencies. And really, our written offers on buying real estate is always loaded with contingencies. You know, contingent on inspection, contingent on lending, contingent on title work. But there could also be that proverbial contingency, contingent on me selling my house. And this gets tricky. Okay, you can have these things and be aware of these and don't say no to a contingency thing, especially if you're in the higher end of properties there, because you're going to need to probably work with those people to get the buyers who want to buy your home, get their home sold. You
right.
just have to be really on target with how contingencies work. And so sometimes really quickly we have what's called a first right of refusal.
Yep.
You've seen that, Chris.
Absolutely.
And so that first right of refusal says essentially this. It says, okay, the seller's going to go ahead and accept your offer, Mr. Buyer, there, but but they're going to give you a first right refusal, which means that if another offer comes their way that they like better, they give you so many hours or so many days, usually maybe 72 hours,
to
basically remove your sale contingency. And you just have to be really careful with that. Needless to say, if you need to know more about how to do that and how does that really work, yeah, I got the answer. Call me, 720-373-0654, or send me an email, Cheryl, C-H-E-R-Y-L, at DenverRealty.com. Hey, we'll be right back with more from the Denver Radio Real Estate Show and learn about lending from Chris Z.
Chris Z.
We'll be right back.
If you're looking for your dream home or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl understood my needs and focused on the properties that most interested me and helped me determine which property would be worth the investment of a lifetime.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interest. Call Cheryl today, 720-373-0654, or online at DenverRealty.com.
Education, the key to success in life. Red Rocks Institute of Colorado can give you that key. Classes, events, workshops, and webinars. We can help you learn and give you a platform to teach your passion. Red Rocks Institute offers a wide variety of classes from money management, real estate, investments, mortgage, insurance, retirement planning, and more. Red Rocks Institute, an adult education center designed to empower people with knowledge. For more information, go to redrocksinstitute.com.
Welcome back to the Denver Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock at Colorado Front Range Property. So glad you guys could join us today. We cannot have your house falling apart, can we?
No way.
Okay. Hey, listen, I want to go ahead and mention to you guys, if you are thinking, you know, about selling your home at all, putting it on the market, you want to get an idea as to what it might be worth, go to DenverRealty.com. And if you scroll right below the panoramic image, you'll see a little market snapshot with a little image with the pink piggy bank in the house. So it's a really cool thing there. It's an instant report, you might say, well, pretty instant, like within about 20 minutes, something like that. It compiles all this data that you put in and cross searches other solds that are really pertinent to what your property is and gives you an estimated analysis. You'll need to call me to get some better explanations, but it gives you great insight to the market and for your area there. And that's great if you're selling a home. Also, if you're buying a home, you're trying to check out market trends. That's really a great tool. It's called Market Snapshot. Go to DenverRealty.com. Scroll right below the panoramic image there, and you'll see the little pink piggy bank there.
What a great tool.
It is a great tool. It's a great tool. I love that website.
Especially in this hot market. You got to, you know, have a good idea of what you're trying to sell or trying to buy.
Yeah, you need to. And you need to know your neighborhoods. You need to track the values in those neighborhoods. So that's really a big deal. So, you know, Chris is Audra. Chris Z. We renamed
Chris
him.
Chris Z.
We call him Chris Z. Anyway, listen, let me tell you here with Homebridge Financial Services, and we are going to go ahead and talk a little bit about mortgages here as far as what people need to know.
Yep.
Because right now is a really great time to be a buyer in today's market. What's the 30-year fixed rate going right now?
You know, they're bouncing anywhere from that on a conventional 4.25 to 4.75. The market's kind of been hovering in that 4.5 range, mm-hmm. you know, for a little while.
And the government rate, what's the government for FHA?
Those are definitely down much more into that low 4 range.
Like 4?
4.25, again, yeah. Depending on the market. The market's a little cranky right now just because some of the economic numbers are, you know, coming in slightly better than what, you know, they were hoping for, which is good for the economy, not good for rates. So,
yeah, right.
But, yeah.
Doesn't that sound weird? Good for the economy, not good for the rates.
Yep, huh? Bond market typically goes opposite of the economy. I mean, that's why we've had such fantastic rates over the last several years is, you know, obviously we've been kind of going through this recession, I guess
that's
is
right.
what they call it.
Now, let me just tell you guys something. I'm going to tell you right now, that is not going to last. We've been saying this for a long time.
Yep.
And I know that we've had these seductively low interest rates for a long time, and that's really what I call them, seduction, basically. Okay. They will not last, okay? And you need to go ahead and take advantage of these rates while you can, because you know what happens, Chris, when people call me? They're always going to say to me, well, okay, I want a house and I only want to pay $1,200 a month.
Yep.
I want to pay $1,500. I want to pay $1,800. Okay, well, if you wait,
it's only going to be that much more.
Well, and yeah, and they don't realize that same house, same size, same square footage, same price With the interest rate adjusted, say a point difference, depending on what you're talking about, could be a $200 difference, yep. Could be a $500 difference in your payment.
Yep, it definitely makes a big difference. And, you know, I always tell people, too, because there's always people that say, I want to catch the bottom of the market and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, you can't catch the bottom of the market. I mean, it's just like, you know, when you're dealing, you know, going after the stock market or whatever, you don't know you're in the bottom until you're past it. But, you know, we're still in a perfect time frame. I mean, prices are you know, still reasonable for where we're at.
Mm-hmm.
Rates are fantastic, even though they're not necessarily at the bottom. And so you can buy $10,000 to $15,000 more houses.
You know,
I've
been in this industry for 30 some years here, and it's about as bottom of a market rate. I mean, I don't think most of our grandparents got rates at 4%.
Yeah, it definitely. I mean, 4% was something that you got on an arm, and it would change the day after. So.
Absolutely. You know, earlier at the top of the show, I was talking about contingencies. You
right.
know, dealing with contingencies and buying and selling property there.
Yep.
And, you know, one of the things that I think as a listing agent, you know, when you're representing a seller on a property, you've got to make absolutely certain, okay, absolutely certain here that when you're taking that property off the market here and going to basically accept a contract from
right.
somebody, that they are thoroughly, that buyer is thoroughly qualified to do so.
Correct.
Because you could waste a lot of valuable marketing, 30, 45, 60 days.
Yeah. And, you know, sure, we're in that time of year where, you know, obviously because of Colorado's weather, I mean, we typically see our market anywhere from, you know, our market gets hot anywhere from February, March, April, somewhere in that window, all the way typically until, you know, about September when the kids go back to school, and then it kind of picks up just a little bit, mm-hmm. you know, and kind of slows down in the wintertime. And so we're in the hot market right now. I mean,
right.
July is, you know, one of the busier, probably one of the busiest months that we deal with. And so, you know, like what you're talking about before, our market's hot. And so, you know, when you go into, you know, we've been talking about over the last few shows about getting pre-qualified and getting yourself in a position where, you know, you're ready to go when you go find that house. Just like you said, if I'm a seller or I'm a selling agent, I want to know, because again, there's only so many days in the summertime that it's hot.
Mm-hmm.
And I want every single buyer I can to come in and potentially, you know, take this house and buy it from us. And so, you know, having a situation where having a contingency, like the sale of your home as an example, one is bad enough.
Mm-hmm.
But then if you come in and, you know, basically have two, meaning I've
got
to sell my
home. It's a big domino theory.
Yeah, I've got to sell my home and I haven't talked to a lender yet. You know, the seller, you know, those are not necessarily marks on the correct side of the chart. You know, they're negatives against you. And so if somebody else comes in with an equal offer with one of, you know, one less contingency or no contingencies, all of a sudden now you're in a completely different negotiation process.
Right. And, you know, you definitely have to have your ducks in a row
yep.
here. And you cannot say, you cannot just go ahead and start saying that, oh, I talked to the bank. Yeah, I can qualify. Yeah. Well,
right.
I want to see it in writing.
Yep.
Where is your pre-qual letter? And better yet, your pre-approval letter. Tell them what the difference is between pre-qual and pre-approved.
You know, pre-qual basically means, you know, we play the 20 question game. You know, I talk to you on the phone, I ask you all the crazy questions, you know, whatever you tell me I use, and then, you know, basically, does it work, does it not work? That would be a pre-qual.
Yeah.
Pre-approval, and there's different variations to this, but pre-approval means that I've collected your documentation, I've verified that you do make X, you know, whatever per hour or salary or commissions or whatever.
You have, you know, a real bank account.
Yeah, you have a real bank account with no funny money in it, if you will. You know, and basically, you know, we've kind of verified that. The really tricky ones we actually send into an underwriter and even take a look at them beforehand.
Right.
You know, so, but that we want to get to that pre-approved process. You know, even one of the things we're going to talk about here in a few minutes is we're going to talk about investment properties. That's even more critical when you start looking at that. Because again, you got to remember, investment properties are still part of the hot market. Okay. There's not nearly as many as what they used to be, and they're not necessarily at the bottom end of the range like they've used to be. But, you know, when you go in and you're buying either a primary home or you're buying an investment property, you've got to make sure, because the investment rules are so much different.
Oh, they are tremendously different.
Credit's a bigger deal. How much you put down is a major deal. So there's all kinds of different things that, you know, when you start looking at buying an investment and when we get in a position where, you know, Tracy's going to be talking about a 1031 exchange, you know, we want to make sure that people are doing what they need to do up front so that they don't get themselves in trouble, because there's some major rules around a 1031 exchange.
Oh,
that
there
can
are
get you in trouble.
You guys, I've got to tell you, Chris Z is so right about that. There are some major, major rules about that. And if you miss your step, sorry, Charlie, you cannot go back. And as Tracy is going to definitely share with us here. Hey, we've got a lot more to tell you on the Denver Radio Real Estate. So, hey, the number to call us at is 720-373-0654, 720-373-0654.
If you're looking for your dream home or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl did an incredible job of creating a virtual tour of our house and property, which was very appealing and professionally done. Cheryl was in constant communication and offered very sound and professional advice.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interest. Call Cheryl today, 720-373-0654 or online at denverrealty.com.
Education, the key to success in life. Red Rocks Institute of Colorado can give you that key. Classes, events, workshops, and webinars. We can help you learn and give you a platform to teach your passion. Red Rocks Institute offers a wide variety of classes from money management, real estate, investments, mortgage, insurance, retirement planning, and more. Red Rocks Institute, an adult education center designed to empower people with knowledge. For more information, go to redrocksinstitute.com.
Ain't that America, something to see, baby? Ain't that America, home of the free, yeah. Little pink houses for you and me.
Welcome back to the Denver Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties, and we got some great American properties to tell you about today right here in our wonderful, great Metro Denver area, don't we, Chris?
Absolutely. These houses are not falling down.
And they are not falling down. I want to welcome back to the show, too, Tracy Wilson with is it 1031 IPX?
IPX 1031 Exchange.
Okay, well, I got it mixed up. Anyway, you put it in either way you like. I think you guys will come up with Tracy Wilson and Chris Z. We've renamed his name. Chris Z, you better tell your office that you got a new
name. I know,
name.
I better change that.
You better change that there. Okay, Chris Z at Homebridge Financial Services here. You guys, if I'm going to tell about some properties here that are for sale right now. And of course, you know, there's a ton that are for sale here, but we need more and more properties there. But these are three that I selected for today's show. But if you've missed the details on these or you want to see these, go to denverrealty.com. Click on the Denver Radio tab. You'll see the property showcase section right there, and you can get all the pictures on all these properties and some additional details on them. Also, while you're at denverrealty.com, please use the Search Homes tab. You are going to absolutely love it. You can create your own account right there to search the Realtors Coveted MLS in real time, and I do mean real time. This is far better than any Zillow, far better than any Realtor.com, far better than any Redfin and Trulia. This is the real McCoy. You get to tap into the Realtors MLS, and that's where all the information those other sites get anyway.
Yep, it's all more, it's accurate.
It's much more accurate, much more up to date, because everybody always calls me later on, it's a day late and a dollar short, yep. You know, kind of routine.
And so where's the link for that?
That's at denverrealty.com. Denverrealty.com, click on the Search Homes tab. You can create your own account. You can get emails automatically daily, however you set it up, for any brand new listings. I have a client right now that told me just the other day, wow, we finally got one here. We keep missing them by hours, and it's only been on the market 3 days. That seemed like a long time.
Yeah.
You know? So, okay, this very first property I got to tell you guys know the Highlands.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, we're not talking Highlands Ranch. I'm talking the Highlands, you know, up by Spear and I-25-ish, that kind of general vicinity. Really great, great area there.
A cool part of town.
It is a cool. It's a happening part
up
of town.
Up and coming, and it's older homes, obviously.
Yeah, there's a great... oh, God, what is it? What do we call them? They're not a saloon. Why am I thinking a saloon? Sports bar or something up that way? But anyway, they got a great place up there called Ziggy's for blues music. It's great. I love the blues. So anyway, this home is a great bungalow-style home, $649.9. It features four bedrooms, three baths, almost 3,500 square feet, two-car detached garage, I should say, completely remodeled top to bottom. It's beautiful.
Beautiful. It looks brand spanking new, even though it's a very old, obviously, home.
Yeah, let's see. It was built in 1915, but
the kitchen looks completely refurbished. It's awesome.
Absolutely. Okay, now moving towards the center part of town, I got to tell you about a home that is a Tudor-style-like home in Hilltop. This one is absolutely gorgeous. Just a little over 5,200 square feet, four bedrooms, four baths, priced at $1.195 with a two-car attached garage. This home was built in 2001, a total custom home with a main floor master.
You mean $1.1 million, right?
Yeah, $1.1 million.
It's a beautiful house. What a beautiful house.
Absolutely. It's just wonderful. You know, over in that Hilltop Park, Hilltop and East Capitol Hill area there, you guys got to call me on these homes, 720-373-0654 if you want some more information. 720-373-0654. 573-0654. Now, for those of you who are looking to spend a little less money, okay, I have found a condo in Lakewood. This one is absolutely just beautiful. Priced at $207,500. 3 bedrooms, 2 baths, 1,327 square feet. It's got a carport and one reserved parking space. And the HOA fee, guys, is $191.
Holy cow. Wow, that's awesome.
That is low. That is low considering today's market for condos.
The best part about this, especially with, you know, how warm it's been. It's got a pool.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Amenities
look
great.
Amenities look awesome.
I think it even has tennis courts, if I remember there. But, hey, you know what? If you wanted to buy that one, just out of a quick idea there, think about it this way. If FHA 30-year rate with 4% interest rate, 30-year fixed rate deal, 3.5% down, your principal and interest payment is only about $956. Give me a call, 720-373-0654, and visit my website at denverrealty.com to search homes. Use your mouse to find a house. We'll be right back with more from the Denver Radio Real Estate Show.
If you're looking for your dream home or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl understood my needs and focused on the properties that most interested me and helped me determine which property would be worth the investment of a lifetime.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interest. Call Cheryl today, 720-373-0654, or online at denverrealty.com.
Country roads take me home to the place.
Welcome back to the Denver Radio Real Estate Show with Cheryl Garlock here at Colorado Front Range Properties. Thank you, Joe, my producer. He does such a great job on bringing on some new tunes, and I always like it. I almost forget I'm doing a radio show here and start thinking I'm in some music festival.
Almost wanted to start singing with it.
Yeah, I did. Absolutely. You know, Willie, wasn't it?
That was John Denver.
John Denver. Okay. Yeah. God dang it. I never pass those darn quizzes, you know? But anyway. Hey, you guys, I have got Tracy Wilson with IPX 1031 Exchange, which is really stands for Investment Property Exchange Services. So I got to ask you, have you ever heard of the word of an exchange, you know, a 1031 exchange or a tax deferred exchange, maybe called a swap?
Yeah, that's right. They do.
Does that work?
Do they sometimes call them? They call them Starker exchanges, named after the court case that started it all.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Tell everyone, Tracy, what an exchange is, okay, and why it comes into play.
Simply put, you know, you own investment real estate, not owner-occupied. It's not your personal primary residence, but it's any other type of real estate. When you sell it, you've got some sort of gain or profit, you're going to have to pay the taxes, the capital gains taxes on it.
Doggone it, Uncle Sam wants.
Unless you do a tax-deferred 1031 exchange. 1031 just talks about that small part of the tax code that if the clients obey all the rules, buy some other piece of property, the gain gets rolled over or deferred, and they don't have to pay those capital gains taxes, which can be huge.
They can be huge, and a lot of times people don't realize that, and especially, you know, when you have such a hot real estate market, I mean, a lot of times people might keep that property and rent that property out, and then they might go ahead and buy another home for them to live in,
right.
And and that's a great idea, but you've got to plan.
Yes.
And at some point in time, you're going to pay the piper. You either got to sell it within, how many years did we decide, the first 3 years?
After you moved out, yes.
Yeah, after you moved out of that home there, you got to sell it within that time frame to go ahead and take advantage of the capital gains exemption.
That's right.
You know, to be able to go ahead and write any of that gain off. Otherwise, and they do not bend a bit on this, do they, Tracy?
No exceptions, no extensions, nothing to the rules.
Now, you know, something else that's really important about being really critical about the rules, it's writing your deal. And when you write your deal, you cannot remember after the fact, or I'm sitting here at the closing and I touched a little piece of my, oh, no, wait a minute, I'm going to hand that back, and I want to do an exchange. Can't do it like that, can you?
No, you have to have a qualified intermediary. That's what we are. You have to have us involved before the closing. So, in other words, we have to produce a set of documents that the IRS requires. They have to be done and sitting there at the closing table.
Right. Now, so let's talk about the intermediary for a second here, because the intermediary is the person that's, or the entity that's going to be holding the cash. So when you do an exchange, you cannot touch any of that money. You from just the second you close on it, you never touch it. You have to have an intermediary do that. It does not mean your Uncle Bob.
That's exactly right.
It does not mean Uncle Bob. Okay.
And so, in fact, sometimes clients will try and use their own accountant or their own attorney to do the exchange. And if that accountant or attorney or whoever has done any work for the client, directly or indirectly within the previous 2 years, they are disqualified and they cannot, should not be doing the exchange for the client.
Wow. Yeah. So let's talk about finding a good intermediary here, because we've had some bad times. And
our industry has had a number of black eyes and a lot of qualified intermediaries literally stealing the monies. I don't know if you ever watched the TV show American Greed.
I love that show. Oh, yeah, I do.
3-4 weeks ago, they had one of the qualified intermediaries who acquired a firm here in Denver.
Yeah.
$155 million of exchange proceeds were missing.
Oh, just a few bucks, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, if that is your retirement plan, and, you know, American Greed does a lot of this stuff with it, people who've lost all their money, you know, and they trusted somebody else there and they've lost, it's because you're not doing your own due diligence.
You bet. You need to search for a qualified intermediary to facilitate your exchange that is bonded, that is insured, that has deep financial pockets, and more so that has rules and procedures in place that even if they tried to do something illegal, they couldn't.
Right.
And
right.
That's one reason I would hope that they would take a look at us.
Okay. Well, and I'm going to just tell you, guys, really here, really quickly here. What happened? Oh, here it is. I want you guys to make a note of this here. If you want to go ahead and check out Tracy, you can give him a call, 303-883-5846, 883-5846, or visit him on the web at ipx1031.com. Listen, if you want to call me, 720-373-0654, I'll definitely connect you.
You know, I think the other thing that's important that, you know, we were talking about earlier is you know, having somebody with the knowledge. Because, again, you know, I've been around Tracy for a few years and just knowing this whole process, it's tricky. And, you know, if you make one misstep, it's all over.
You're toast.
And let's talk about how much those capital gains might be.
Absolutely.
Because that's a big deal.
Yeah, for many, many years under President Bush, people thought capital gains, they were 15%. You sell some piece of real estate, it's at a $10,000 gain. Then about $1,500 you would have been out the door in capital gains taxes. That changed significantly last year.
Yeah, just this past year.
So capital gains now is either 15% or 18.8%. Or 23.8%, because you have to add the 3.8%.
Oh, that's right.
Medicare surtax.
Yep. That's right.
On with the capital gains, and that capital gains, those three numbers I just mentioned, were for the gain on the appreciation.
Right.
There's also recapture of depreciation because it's investment real estate.
You know what? I can only
that's
tell you 25%. One thing.
25%.
Yes, wow. Tracy, we need to have Tracy back. Don't you guys agree? I know we need to have Tracy back here on the show here to talk more about investment exchange properties there. So, hey, that wraps it up for our show today. Thank you so much for joining us today. But if you've got a question for Chris Z or Tracy Wilson from IPX 1031 Exchange or me, Cheryl Garlock at Colorado Front Range Properties, yeah, give us a call. Reach us at 720-373-0654. Visit us on the web at denverrealty.com.
You've been listening to Denver Radio Real Estate with Cheryl Garlock, a show about all things real estate and home-related for Denver and Colorado. Go to denverrealty.com to sign up for special offers and events. Listen to past shows, read educational articles, and find links to all your home and real estate needs. Cheryl would love to hear from you. For questions and show ideas, email info@denverrealty.com.
Oh, the house is a rockin' on by